Yo, what is up, guys? It is Spooky.
Hi, Spooky.
What's good, Adam?
We've never commentated together.
Nope, this will be the first time.
Hi, everyone. I'm Keats, and you're about to see some mystery action.
Yes.
Before we jump in, you know, maybe a little tour of the history of Mystery Game.
So, Mystery Game, the tournament itself, this is a long-running series. It's been going since UFGT days, essentially.
Well, even before that, actually. Yep. I used to go to Midwest Championships run by Jason Wilson.
Yes.
And he always ran the, you know, the famous Mystery Game tournament. So it was like, you know, 32-man. That was big back in the day, by the way.
Yep.
32-man Mystery Game tournaments. Those were at an arcade. So we'd run through the arcade, and he'd just, like, pick random games. We'd be playing skee-ball and stuff. And then when I started running, I ran Midwest Championships for 1 year, and I had to carry on the tradition of Mystery Game. So we kind of moved it to consoles that year. That was when Street Fighter IV came out. And we started getting all these classic consoles and making it really legit. We got 128 people. We capped the bracket. And we've capped the bracket every year since then, and it always caps first.
Yep.
Because people want to be part of Mystery Game.
They really want to try it out. Why not?
And here we are. We're doing it again at Combo Breaker 2016. 128 people, whittled down to four. Just four people left.
Coming up first is going to be the winner's final, and we're getting them ready on the stage right now, of course.
That's
this is
going to
be a really fun game, I hope, for everybody involved.
Yeah, it's going to be something, Spooky. Mystery Game, always known for wild highs and lows, you know. Sometimes we have something great for you, and sometimes we have what you're about to see next.
So the players actually don't know. There it is.
Here we go. So we're going to be playing a little Dead or Alive Extreme Beach Volleyball. It's not just beach volleyball. It is extreme
beach volleyball. Oh, you saw that block. Oh man, this looks amazing.
You can play on several different beaches in this game, I guess. I've never actually played this. Is it a legitimate volleyball game?
I don't think so. I think it's pretty bad, but we'll see. It kind of reminds me of that old game Super Spike V-Ball for Nintendo.
Super Spike was legit.
Yeah,
that game was pretty
this
fun.
This is not as good.
All right. You can choose from, looks like, eight thrilling characters.
Yeah, so the way it works is that each player gets a partner, and the rules we set for this is that they must use the usual option for their partner, which is, like, the normal setting.
Unwilling. Wow.
Unwilling. The faces change, by the way, when you pick that, so
I want a confident partner.
Yeah. We tried it with the confident and the other one. The confident one actually is way too helpful.
Okay.
And then the first one just does nothing. So.
Sure. So when you pick your character, too, it takes it off the roster. So there's no mirror matching allowed.
Okay. Nice.
These guys look like they've played this before.
They have.
Oh, my God. This is super, super legit.
This is amazing.
Okay, okay.
Nice first point.
That's out of bounds. Yep. Is this a replay? No. Okay.
No. There's no replays or anything. They just jump right back into it. Sometimes, like, a character will make a reaction, and that's it. Wow, these guys have definitely played before.
The camera, like, wiggling between the two sides. I'm getting a little nauseous. I'm not going to lie.
This looks, like, 10 times better than when we were playtesting this, by the way.
These guys are so good. How many hours have you two sunk into this game? Be honest. Just shout it out.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. Destroyed.
Nice,
what a save.
This is ridiculous. Katomi.
The sandy formation tech is actually pretty sweet. Kudos to the
nice
to Team Ninja.
1-1.
The sand is perfectly smooth between every point as well.
Okay. So 2-1 in favor of Cows right now. Sir, basic stuff.
Oh, Mr. Igloo almost with a huge drop.
Okay, good recovery there.
Man.
Still in there. Nice. Oh,
that's
not
tough.
Not enough.
Cal's definitely showing that he's spent some time playing Extreme Beach Volleyball.
What is this song?
I don't know, but I'm
Please.
Liking it. Somebody find this for me on Spotify. Oh, wow. That was completely unchecked.
Right.
Not even an attempt to stop that one.
So Cal's starting to run away with it a little bit here. It is to 7.
Yeah, Cal's in control for sure. But Igloo doesn't look lost, you know?
No, he definitely, like I said, he's playing this way better than I was when we were testing, for sure.
Occasionally,
okay.
You pop a mystery game up here, and somebody's played it, and the other guy hasn't, and they just look absolutely lost.
Oh,
double spike!
Great blocks on that.
We finally have a spike.
Spike
mystery
again?
Oh.
Yeah. Looking good, she says.
Spike. I'm getting seriously dizzy from this camera.
Yeah, I feel like somehow Cows is spiking the ball a lot harder than Igloo is. Oh, there we go.
Oh,
that was almost recovered.
Yeah, that counts though. Should we look up the lyrics of this song and sing along?
No idea. Who is even singing? I hope this is not like.
Oh.
All right,
2-6. This is the 7s. This is match point.
Okay.
Serve does get return bump set.
Oh, be careful. Oh,
whoa. That was silly.
Nice block.
Wow, really good block.
All right.
Cal's in firm control. This is 2 out of 3?
It is 2 out of 3. That's okay. Correct.
All so right. Igloo could adjust.
He can change his characters if he wants, but I don't know if they're going to bother with that. We'll see.
Does it matter?
I don't know. I have no idea. Maybe some characters are faster than others and some spike harder or something like that, but...
I didn't see any stats on character select, so I have no idea. Wow, they are just attacking the net. Set and spike. Nice. Unchecked. Character's out of position.
Okay, set. Oh. Cal's game number one, by the way. Nice.
Was she cleaning her foot before she returned the ball?
You have to be careful, too. Like, let's say you die for the ball. There's so much recovery after that if you go too early or you mistime it, the ball's gone. You lost.
Right.
That's why I'm so surprised how well these guys are doing. I was mistiming so much stuff.
Okay. Yeah, they're in position pretty often. We've only seen a few severe spikes go completely unchecked.
Okay, nice set. Another set. That was not too aggressive there. Nice spike.
There.
Another spike.
How long is the recovery on that knockdown? Is really long.
Oh, yeah. She was saved by her partner there, for sure. Okay. Spike again. Good block. Counter spike.
Oh, wow.
They are going in so hard.
They are. Oh. Nothing but net. That's a sports term.
Is it really? I may have played that game. Spike. Oh.
Wow.
Missed on the dive.
Actually, would have liked to see the replay on that. That was questionable.
Oh,
okay. That's the first failed serve we've seen. Gives a point to Mr. Igloo. Gives him control of the ball. And another failed serve. Okay. New trend.
So this game actually has analog buttons because Xbox has the analog buttons. So I believe the harder that you press is how you get the harder spike.
Interesting. I wonder if the players know that.
Oh, they hopefully know now if they didn't know before. Set.
Wow. That changes everything. I think you just gave them the game-winning
last
tech.
Last piece of info they needed, huh?
Cal's about to close it out. Wow. Oh, game
man,
set.
He tried to get the block.
Cal
that was
takes
it.
All
right, so that was our winner's final.
Sure was.
That was cool.
Mr. Igloo is going to take a little trip to the loser's bracket where he will await the winner of the loser semifinals, which is going to be Mr. Justin Wong.
Woo!
Yeah.
Let's go, Justin.
Versus Husbando.
Yeah. So, Husbando, I believe this guy is also a longtime mystery game player, if I'm not mistaken.
Definitely.
All right.
Yeah, Jay Wong always enters the mystery game tournaments.
He always does really well,
I think. His luck has been a little hard for the last few years, though. I've done mystery game tournaments with him at other events and, you know, made top three, top four with him. But at the UFGT and Combo Breaker ones, he's had pretty sour luck for the last 3 or 4 years. So nice. It's good to see him return to the main stage and play some wacky stuff.
Yeah, I think that, you know, one thing about Justin is that he's really good in the player versus player matchup. So see how that goes.
Sounds good.
Hyping up the big house. Check him out, guys. Okay. Negative. Yeah, it looks like. All right, guys. So once again, check out the big house. Apologies for that there. In Dearborn, Michigan, October 7th through the 9th. For you, all you Smash Monsters out there, they got Melee and they have Smash 4. Smash Brothers for Wii U. Much love. And once again, guys, we are transitioning to the next game. So just hang tight. We're going to be set up shortly. And, of course, thanks, guys, to Keats. Make sure to give him a shout-out, everyone. The Keats on Twitter. All right, Frosty Faustings. I love this tournament. Great, great tournament. Hello, David. How are you, sir?
What up, man?
What's going on? Anyway, guys, once again, make sure to check out Frosty Faustings. They got a new venue, great Midwest tournament, super anime, by the way. So if you love anime games, you definitely need to go to this. Elvin Shadow, great, great organizer. He's run this event for years and years. Please check him out, frostyfaustings.com. Rubicon, Chicago's monthly. Check him out. Melee every day. News, photos, videos, and all that stuff. Check him out on social media. Melee every day. Cool.
Hey, all right, welcome to me. I know, it's already been here. Everything. Man, that volleyball, the volleyball was really good, actually. Dude, I gotta say, people knew what was going on.
Playing. Yeah, when we tested that, we were like, okay, these guys are, somebody's gonna get like 7-0 because he figured out how to spike, and the guy just doesn't.
Oh, they were in there. That was legit.
Definitely running it. And if you're wondering why I'm looking up, we have like this huge projector right here. This is like the best thing ever. So I'm just staring at myself on like a giant,
it's really big
size screen. Yeah. It's awesome.
Yeah. And we can actually hear ourselves talk like over the mic, over the loud. Yeah, there it is.
Oh,
look at that.
It is.
Hey,
so awesome.
This is us.
Look at that. Looks great. I like the signs on the side, combo breaker. When Rick was up here talking, it had his name on the side.
Yeah, yeah, it's so awesome.
It looks great. All right. So it looks like they're almost ready to set up on the stage. Got Husbando on the left, and on the right, Mr. EG Justin Wong representing.
Man, Justin Wong making it into top four, huh?
Yeah, he's very good at these mystery game tournaments. Yeah. Every now and then he has a little random trouble, but yeah, you know, can be like that for anything.
You know, people think that the mystery game is all about random games and that there's not sort of long-term skill, but I don't think that's true. It's about how quickly you can adapt, how quickly you can find things or experiment. And then, look, a lot of these games have sort of those fundamentals of spacing, reactions, all that stuff. And the more of that you have, the longer you can go in the tournament.
The main thing that you have to understand coming into it is that everything is a mystery, okay? The game that you're going to play is a mystery. The amount of lag on the setup you're going to play on is a mystery. You know what I mean? Even the rules of the game are a mystery, right? So when you come into it with that mentality and you're completely prepared, you know it goes really well. There are techniques that I don't see a lot of people use that are very effective. For example, just let's say you're playing a typical fighting game and the other guy picks a character and he beats the crap out of you, right? Well, one thing to do is sometimes mirror match them because they've done all the groundwork for you, right? They know how to play their character. And sometimes what will happen is because you switch, let's say you beat them in the mirror, they switch off, which is actually the worst thing you can do because now you know how to play their character and they have to like learn a new character on the fly.
Yeah, once somebody finds some real BS that you can really abuse, you know, it's better to abuse it. Oh, man, all right.
So this is Battle Monsters, for Sega Saturn. I'm not sure if anyone at home has even seen this game because this is my first experience with it.
I've definitely never seen it. I'm loving the names.
Look at these names. So everyone's a monster. There's like a Frankenstein character.
Deathmask.
Cheyenne.
I'm not sure how to pronounce that one.
Chili and pepper. What was that?
Well, yeah, there was a strawberry jam, I think. Oh, why would you go with the boring one? Did you see this dude pick the human? Why are you the human?
Oh, man.
Come on, Justin.
Jago says
against,
someone in the
again,
crowd.
I'm not sure what that says.
Albiole, I don't know. It's
Oh, yeah, Albiole. Sure. Wow, that dude. Oh, okay, so there's a platform up there.
Yeah, you can jump around and stuff. There's a lot of movement. There's a run. I think there's a backdash. I don't really know if it actually is a backdash or you just move back.
Any idea what the birthday cake is at the bottom? Is that the health?
I think so. Yeah, the candles at the bottom are the health. And that thing in the middle, I guess, is the timer. Santa time? I don't know. I've never seen this go to a time over. Usually someone just gets beat up really badly.
Okay.
The weird red icons at the top are actually the rounds.
Oh, okay, cool. Well, I like Justin just hanging out on top there. Oh, wow. Albiole can shoot up. That seems really good in this kind of game. Yeah, nice movement, though.
Yeah, it's... Jumping around is pretty weird. The button layout is a little weird, too. When you first play, you're like, whoa, you expect your punches to be in a certain place, but they're actually not where you think they are.
Oh, okay.
All types of stuff. It's weird.
Oh, Justin pressuring.
Okay.
Corner control.
They both have about this. Oh, there we go. Justin's got a little up.
Oh, sick anti-air on purpose.
What was that? We need him.
Oh, wow, over. Time over. Look, at
look at that. That's the first time I've seen that happen. Of course, when Justin's playing.
Right, yeah.
Not a surprise.
Justin staying away. I really like that Albiole can control. I'd love to see more of those fireballs. Yeah.
I think he's trying to figure out. Oh, there we go. He's trying to figure out if he has more specials, I bet.
Okay. Well, he found something. Oh, sick. What a call out.
That was cool.
Look at them playing footsies going back and forth. Come on, guys.
Oh, he's got it. Oh,
look at this.
So
look at this.
One thing that you may or may not have noticed is that no one has really blocked yet, except there. I have not figured out how you actually block properly. I'm not sure if you hold back or if you press a button to block or what. Sometimes it feels like I can block and sometimes it feels like I'm just gonna hit. It's really weird.
No more staying away for Justin, seems.
Oh, no, he's going away. He's got to figure out a way to get out. That was a start.
What a whiff punish, I guess.
He figured out a new move there.
Okay. Dang, Justin can still do this. Come on, Husbando. Come on, Husbando.
Okay.
There
nice.
It
Jabbed
is.
Him out. All right. So one round apiece. This is a 2 out of 3 set, by the way.
Okay. So they have some time to figure things out.
round three. So loud.
He just falls down. You see that?
Yeah. If you walk off the platform, that's what happens. And it makes you trip.
Nice. Justin, outranging. Waiting for that whiff punish opportunity. Okay.
Okay. He's got to find a way to get in. Oh, man, that jab seems really annoying and fast.
That little tail flip there?
Yeah. Okay. Oh, that didn't work out how you wanted.
Wow.
Husbando. Whoa, what was that? All right, Husbando has a pretty good lead. He's trying to play the zone game and be up. Jump's so horrible.
Yeah, I know.
Hit him on the way down.
Ooh! Oh! All right, so if you're Justin now, do you stick with Shion?
I don't know.
What do you do? I mean, he's seen that Albiol has fireballs. You know, yeah, he has a distance game, but he doesn't know what those commands are.
Let's see what the obstacle is.
Heat.
Albiol. Okay.
Naga.
Death mask.
Yeah, the strawberry jam. Oh, look at this guy. Oh, beautiful.
All right, strawberry jam.
Is he gonna always gonna run it on strawberry jam?
All right.
We'll see what happens. Strawbelly. Excuse me. Yeah. Even better.
All right.
Very serious expression.
Yep. Game number two. For us, it's all fun, but for them, hey, they're trying to win.
Of course.
Oh, what is that? Oh man, those fireballs have been way too much damage.
Yeah, he's found a taller character too, and that might be bad news for him.
He's gotta have something. Maybe he has like a command.
Ooh, something happened.
Oh, he has a fireball too?
Pretty short range. Wow, Justin.
Okay.
Trying to make this comeback.
He has like nothing.
Yeah, he has half a candle left. Oh, there was a selective? No.
That might have been a chip kill off, I'm sure.
It's match point now for Husbando.
All right. But Justin was figuring out a little bit there with his character.
Yeah, he found some stuff.
Round two.
That seems like a really good position. Do a little bit of chip and just hang out.
Oh man, they're shabbing each other. That move does so much damage.
Yeah, that's really good.
Okay, nice combo. I think it was a combo. Who knows?
Yeah. S jam.
Oh, you got a juggle there.
Yeah, Justin's found some nice stuff. Just a little stabby stab and then more stab.
It's fast, which is great. You can disrupt those fireballs. That have been the big problem. Oh, you can crouch that.
Wow, that does a lot.
Yes, it does. Oh, he tried to predict the jump in.
Oh! Oh, got him!
Husbando, he takes it. And Justin Wong will be eliminated from the tournament. But he gets fourth.
Yeah, pretty good.
To him. He got really far in the tournament. He played really well.
Yeah, definitely.
All right, so Husbando will stay on. And we'll be switching over to the next game momentarily, guys.
So this will be Losers Finals coming up?
Yes, it is the Losers Final. And it is a different game. Without, they won't be playing Battle Monsters.
Yeah. That's too bad. There's such good characters in there. I'd really like to see them be explored.
Yep.
We'll never see Death Mask.
No. I actually played that character. He's like a Frankenstein.
Yeah?
He's a little slow, but he's got like a command grab.
He's got
this running like lariat thing that's really good.
Okay.
Yeah, he seemed like he was okay.
Basically Jason, sounds like.
Yeah, something. You actually very similar to Jason.
Yeah.
He doesn't have like any the slasher stuff or anything.
Okay.
He doesn't have a weapon. He's just beat down type of character.
Yeah.
Pretty cool.
All right,
guys. So again, we're watching the mystery tournament. Unfortunately, Justin Wong has been eliminated at fourth place, but good stuff to him for getting so far. Well played. Now we have just three players remaining, and it's going to be Mr. Igu versus Husbando, losers final. The next game is a PC game. This is a game that's totally unreleased. So this will be the first time that you guys will get to see this game, period, I believe, worldwide.
Okay.
So pretty cool.
Is it a new game?
Yeah, it's new. It's very fun. I don't want to reveal it.
We'll see it once it comes on.
Yeah, it's really cool. Very old school style gameplay.
Okay. Nice. Well, right now, as the players are getting set up, they have to try to consider, you know, how they're going to adapt. They don't know what it's going to be. They have no idea. It could be. It doesn't even necessarily have to be a fighting game.
So this game is. I bet that Puma's going to explain the rules to them again, but it's very basic. It's just a basic two-button game, and the format will be they play first to 10, and then 2 out of 3.
Okay.
All right. Almost ready?
I guess we'll see what it is.
I can tell based on what they're doing. Hearing where they need to be.
Okay, cool.
Okay, oh, Killer Instinct figures. I love these, by the way. Check them out at UltimateSourceKillerInstinct.com. I really want that full gore. But yeah, they're all awesome. And by the way, when you get these, they're official, and they also unlock an exclusive in-game color if you're in the game, which is that's like the coolest thing that I've ever seen in the game. So check them out.
I agree with you about that full gore. I'm in there. I think that's really good. Okay.
And also check out Paradise Arcade Shop. They're showing up lots of the great Hori parts, including the Real Arcade Pro VLX and the Real Arcade Pro Kai. The VLX, I like to call it the backbreaker, super heavy stick, very sturdy, great if you love that.
I like that.
Yep, and the Kai is great because it's a much more lightweight stick, very easy to travel with. Yeah. Both have the same parts, both will get the job done for you.
Okay, it looks like they're about ready to go.
Alright, so Mr. Igu on the right side of your screen and Husbando on the left side of your screen. Here we go, they're going to jump into it.
So the game is nothing good can come of this, huh?
Nothing good will come of this. It's by the fine folks at Cartwheel Games. So okay. Much love to them for hooking us up with this. And the way it works is really simple. There is a gun and there's a bullet. And you can only shoot the gun by having the bullet, of course, right? So the idea is that you got to pick up both.
Yeah, you got to get both. Got it. Okay. And you can hit each other, I guess?
Yes, you can hit each other as well. So okay, one player's got the gun and the other player's got the bullet. That means that you have to hit the other player to actually take the bullet.
Right, interesting, okay.
Or to take the gun.
Whatever. Well, they're trying to figure out what it is exactly. Oh, yeah, he took the gun. There you go.
All right.
The whiff.
Oh, there's another bullet. He's got the bullet. He's got the gun.
Wow. Wow. get in there. The corner. Yes.
Shot. All right, Husbando has got 3 so far. So one thing you have to watch out for, you may have noticed it, when the gun comes down.
Wow. That was a quick fig. Yeah,
that you finger. Can't just go for it because if it actually lands on you, it stuns you like that.
Oh, look at that. Yeah.
That's to stop you from just camping the center. Same thing with anything that drops down. He's slapboxing him.
You're spotted at distance. Yes.
Boom, headshot. All right, so okay. Mr. Igloo is the guy with the missing block
in
his face. Yeah,
the square versus the block. they're both there!
Matt Husbando's running away.
Oh, man, this
first
is
set.
A blow-up so far.
Slap. Okay, wins.
Mr. Igloo has the bullet.
How did that not hit?
I don't know. Can't let him get the bullet. Oh, that's it.
Oh,
yes.
No.
So quick on the draw.
Yep.
The gun. Oh, he threw the gun. It. Watch out. Watch out.
No.
Okay, maybe a chance now for Igloo. Oh. I love the protection. No. Oh, now he's in trouble. He's in trouble. He's in trouble.
He's got it. No!
Yes.
He tried to preemptively jump and dodge, but once you jump, you're committed, so they can wait for you.
Missed. The whiff. Bullet coming down.
Oh.
Wow. Igloo still has the gun. Oh!
It's so crazy. Slap.
Oh, he threw the gun? Oh, Igloo threw. Yeah, that's it.
Oh, you're
decapitated.
Again. All right, so it's 1-0 in favor of Husbando. And we're going to go on to the second set. Husbando has kind of figured out. Igloo, it's not like he hasn't figured out the buttons and the attacks, but I think Husbando has been real aggressive. Slap.
That's it. Oh, I love it. He's been so good on predicting whether the opponent's going to jump or just reacting.
Yeah. Sometimes waiting is just the best thing.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, they were both stunned.
Yeah, so as you can see, whenever it's bouncing, you really have to wait until it lands.
A chance? Yes. Igloo.
All right, he's on the board. Oh. Oh, no.
Ooh.
Oh, nice.
Still has the gun, though. Yes. Oh, that's bad.
Oh, he missed.
Love the evasion.
All right. Igu Scott center stage.
He's oh, can he get there in time? No.
Oh, wait. He's got the bullet.
Yeah, he still does.
He's got the gun. Nice shot.
Picked up the gun. There's the bullet. Oh!
Whoa.
Husbando with the gun. Oh, you gotta protect the bullet! Or no?
No. So.
Yeah, there it is.
So, the way it works is another bullet won't actually drop down. Oof. Another bullet won't actually drop down unless certain actions happen. I believe you have to either throw the gun or you have to hit another person or something along those lines. Nice. Oh, how did he do that? That was cool.
Oh, nice.
He caught the gun.
Yes, gets the bullet. Smart.
Oh, he missed. I guess you can't get too close, huh? That's happened a few times.
Nice. Oh. Jumps right over. Mm-hmm. Igloo with the gun.
He's got the bullet. Nice. Oh, he.
Where's it coming? Yeah. Oh, yeah. He was just waiting for the landing. Great anti-air.
I wonder if you can attack while you're airborne like that. Maybe he could have come down with a button.
Yeah, that's a good question. Oh, he's...
Oh, you can. Ooh. Okay.
He was in a bad look.
Nice.
All right, bullet, gun, different sides. Trying to play some footsies on the way in. Look at this.
I think it's actually a little unfair that the gun is...
Oh, shot.
The gun is still a weapon, right?
Yeah.
Even if it's not, there's no bullet.
Yeah,
but if you have the bullet, you can't actually do anything with it.
Wow, that was so fast. Five to three. Yes.
I'm just sitting here giggling the entire time. This is so cool.
By the way, I love the sound in the background. It's very atmospheric.
Yeah, I have no idea if there are like more stages or anything like that. Maybe not. This is it.
That's it. Oh, okay. That's good though. I like it. Very suspenseful sound.
Sick. All right, so Mr. Eagle, he's starting to catch up here. It's a very close set so far.
Yeah, 6-5.
You cannot.
Was that a whiff through the opponent?
Yeah. I think that's happened a few times. If you get too close, then the bullet will not actually hit them.
That
was good.
Yes, had to get the bullet there. Okay. Oh chance. No chance. There it is. Yes.
All right. Tied up. Very nice. So serious.
Yeah, I mean, they're shooting and killing each other. Of course it's serious. The whiff!
That was a great jump.
Mm-hmm. Love the timing. Yeah, you can attack in the air. There you go.
Nice.
Oh, say what?
I don't even know.
I'm not sure what happened there. Yeah.
He's got a good lead now. He's starting to figure it out. Mm-hmm. Ooh, nice.
Oh, that's good. Good for him. No. Nice attack.
Oh, he made him do a flip.
Yeah, I love the physics. Oh, wow. Clutch hit.
That was great. Oh,
got it again, though.
He almost defended himself.
So we're tied up here in the round.
He stunned him in midair. And the gun got thrown.
Yes, got the bullet. Too close,
nice.
Though.
Oh,
nice.
So I guess if the gun is loaded and you take it from them, it's still loaded.
It's what it looks like, yeah.
Oh, almost.
It's super quick.
Somebody has to...
Nice. The evasion. Does he have the bullet? No.
He does.
That was so quick.
So what happens when the time runs out?
I don't know. We might find out. We might find out.
Nice shot. Final game.
Look at this. 9-9.
Final round, I should say.
Match point, Husbando.
Oh, my goodness.
Can Igloo stay alive?
Oh, he missed.
Yeah, I think you got to throw. Okay,
yeah, somebody's
got to
take an action.
Yep.
There we go.
Where's he going? Where's he going?
Clutch! Nice! And he gets it! That was ridiculous.
That was so clutch.
All right, final game. Here we go. Again, it'll be another first to 10. The score is 1-1. Early kill for Mr. Igloo to start it off.
That gun. It's ready. It's ready. There it is. Yes. Mm-hmm. I love the patience. A good start. Nice, yeah. Immediately.
And Husbando seems unfazed. He is ready to continue attacking. He's not affected by the end of that previous match.
Oh, too close. Oh. Okay, Igloo has the bullet.
He's got the gun.
Oh, too quick on the draw.
Yep. Give me that.
Bullet in hand. Ooh. Oh. Yeah, it's loaded. It's loaded. It's ready. It's ready.
Nice.
Yes.
Nice shot.
Oh, that was immediate. Mm-hmm. Okay, good news for Igloo. Oh, Nocto! Again, who's got it? Oh, too close!
Oh my goodness.
It's ready. When's he gonna pull it?
Got him. Yo. He almost hit him on the way down. Unfortunately. Not anymore.
The whiff. Okay. Oh, that's ready.
Oh, he missed. Nice save by Igloo.
Can he get it? Yes. Very quick turnaround. 3-3. Tied up. One game apiece.
Got him.
That's good patience.
Yeah, it seems like Husbando is really strong in the first few seconds of the match. Yep.
Yep, he's got it already. Yeah. The preemptive jump and Husbando just waiting.
Yeah, but Igloo has been a lot more successful once he's gotten past these first few seconds. Like here.
Yeah, right. He has the gun now. Oh, that's on his bundle side.
Nice. Oh, yeah, it's loaded. Gun hit it's him ready. On the way down. Yes. No, that was so brutal.
Yeah, what a start. You're right. His bundle consistently doing well at the beginning. Mm-hmm. I think it's ready to go. No. Oh, he moved backwards. He was. I like the idea, but
trying
he was already committed. Yeah.
And again, Husbando has a big lead here, but Igloo has come back in this situation before.
Oh, boy. Yeah, got to get close. Oh, not that close.
Got him in the back.
8-3.
Yep.
Oh, that was so quick. What a read. It's match point. Husbando.
Oh, that was ridiculous. Husbando takes it.
He is so good.
So Mr. Igloo unfortunately eliminated at third place, but good stuff to him. He's played really well this entire weekend, and I hope that he enjoyed. All right.
Yeah, there were a lot of people in this tournament, so to end up with third is an accomplishment.
No, it's 128 people. It was capped completely. Yeah. A couple of people didn't make it on time for their pools, but most of those were actually replaced by people that really wanted to be in the Mr. Tournament.
Yeah, I know. It's really popular. Husbando entered late, huh? Yeah. That's awesome.
Oh, awesome. Good to hear. So Husbando was one of the guys that replaced a slot. And look at that.
That's awesome. Oh, the replay. Oh, God. All the pieces coming out. How gruesome. The red falling everywhere.
That is great. So, again, much love to Cartwheel Games, and thank you to them for providing. Nothing good will come of this for us. Very cool game. I hope that you guys all enjoyed it at home.
Yeah, I really enjoyed watching that. That looks like a blast to play.
Dude, one of my favorite games is the old Atari 2600 game, Combat, and this reminds me of that.
Yeah,
quite
I can see
bit.
That. Yeah.
It's like a new age combat, if you will.
Yeah, okay.
Right, so coming up next is going to be Grand Finals, and it's going to be Kaos, who made it all the way through winners. So he's in a good position right now, and his opponent is Husbando, who's coming from loser's side. That means that Husbando must win two sets in Grand Finals in order to be the winner of the Mystery Game Tournament.
Is that a Super Nintendo up there?
That is a Super Nintendo. Indeed.
Okay.
This is a game that it is very popular in the FGC, I think, especially from old schoolers.
Oh, yeah?
Very cool. Yeah, I think you guys will all love this.
There were a bunch of Super Nintendo fighting games, and a lot of them were terrible.
Oh, yeah, a lot of them were bad.
But some of them were pretty good.
This game, in my opinion, is a good game.
Okay.
I think it's very fun.
Okay.
It's got a very Super Turbo style of gameplay, so I think that you'll also enjoy it as a Super Turbo player yourself.
I see.
Yeah,
all
it's
right.
very fun.
All right.
All right.
Thanks to Gaming Generations for being one of the big sponsors here.
Much
Rentals,
love.
Services. They really provide a good service. You know, they're the people who provide... setups for a lot of the major tournaments in North America.
A large portion of the setups here are from Gaming Generations. Thank you to them. Combo. Oh, I want to see that one. That was the patch, right? Controller Chaos.
Yeah, yeah. I actually picked up one of these controllers by Controller Chaos earlier. It's a Pokken controller.
Oh, nice.
And it has a little galaxy sort of motif on it. It's really sick looking.
Cool. Yeah, these guys are great at customizing controllers in general. If you want to customize your pad and make it look cool, you should definitely talk to Controller Chaos.
Yep, a lot of good stuff there.
All right. And check out Broken Tier. They're showing off QCFP available today. Right now, BrokenTier.com. If you purchase it, you also get a free sticker. I think that some of the other shirts that they have in stock also have the same thing this weekend. So make sure to check them out. Yeah.
Thanks also to Avid for being a major sponsor here, major supporter.
Win your match.
For some reason, Jabali and Hanzo Gonzo are playing.
Hanzo Gonzo will win.
I totally agree. I like Hanzo in this matchup. If you want to challenge your own friends, check it out soon. Avid.com.
They're only playing for $5. Why are there hundreds on the table? And I love this shirt. I really like the design. I didn't even notice at first that it's like bison climbing out from the bottom.
It's one side and the other.
I was so busy looking at Chun-Li's attractive figure.
It's a really cool shirt, man. I like the idea. Splitframe.net.
Yep, make sure to check them out.
So I can think of, I don't know, let's see, Super Nintendo fighting games that...
Are like Super Turbo. This game, I swear, if you've played it extensively, it's like a little faster, but it's basically Super Turbo. It's very similar, even down to like the character's special moves and things like that.
Is it going to be Turtles?
Maybe.
Oh, yeah? Oh, yeah? Okay, all right, let's do this. Sick.
All right.
That is a good game.
By the way, Tapuno was on the stage. If you have forgotten, don't forget to switch the HDMI cable. That part's important.
Spooky anyway. Doing work.
No, I mean, I usually would be on the stage helping out with this process. I know that they're almost ready, so just give them a second.
Yeah, I kind of hope it's Turtles. Mm-hmm. I played that game a bunch. Chrome Dome was my dude.
Oh, yeah, yeah. He's very good.
Look, he's Zangief and awesome and a robot in the same character. You know that's for me.
Oh, man.
Who has an invincible fireball?
Does he really? Is he invincible? I forgot. It's like the spark, right?
Yeah, the spark. Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's his wake up.
Really good.
Yeah.
Now I know why people use that move like that.
Yeah. Oh, that game was really deep.
It's very fun. Anyway, right now they're getting set up on the stage for it. It's going to be really cool. Lots of different characters in this game. Lots of different play styles that you can do. There's no throw breaks or anything like that either. Yeah. So that's not Super Turbo, I guess. You can actually... kind of
you can soften it in Super Turbo. That's it. But yeah, there were a bunch of other fighting games for the Super NES. I owned a lot back in the day, and most of them were pretty crappy.
Yeah.
But some were good. Did you ever play Combat Tribes?
Mm-mm.
No? Okay, that game was not good.
Combat Tribes? Crap. Okay, I'm going to look. Who cares? That's
don't worry.
I've never heard of it. I got to try it now.
Kind of sucked.
Dude, I used to play, I can't remember the name of it. I want to say it was War Gods. It was like this game, and the character I had was a Minotaur, and it would just say, let's rock, like every round. It wasn't Guilty Gear, though. It was so bad.
I don't remember. War Gods? War Gods? That was for 64, right?
Was it? Okay.
I think so.
All right.
The replay, okay. All right. There were some hype replays in that set.
Dude, that was great in general.
I'm looking at the cartridge there. I just can't see. Oh, come on, glasses.
Yeah, it's TF.
It is? Sure. Oh, okay, sick. Yeah. All right, cool. So this is a game that a lot of people know of. Mm-hmm. And even if you're not great at it, like you have probably seen it. If you've been around in the FGC for a while, you've probably seen people play or heard people talking about it. And you're right, a bunch of different character archetypes. There are people who have taken this game seriously. You know, it's legit. Wow, that was brutal.
I love the replay package. Slapped.
Oh,
shot.
That was the
end of the first game. Destroyed him in that game. All right. This was the end of the second game. This was a great ending.
Yeah, that was so good. Steals it.
Himself.
Yeah.
He was like mashing the shot.
Look at this dude. He was hyped.
Okay. Up shot. All right.
Oh, yes.
Yep. Man, yes.
Tournament Fighters.
Let's go. All right, so Cows is coming from the winner's side, and Husbando is coming from loser's side.
Oh,
however,
sounds...
I will say that if we if they do reset the bracket, they will not play this game. They will play a different game.
Oh, cool.
So we'll see what happens.
All right, all right. So where are they going to go? Raph? Raph and Asuka.
All right. Okay, they're jumping right into it. This is a 3 out of 5 because it is the grand final.
Round one.
Okay, so somebody has played this game before, probably.
And, all right. Power drill started off.
Nice, the little punish there.
Nice uppercut. Oh, these guys know how to play a little
yeah,
bit.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
All right. Raphael considered, very strong. By
yeah, Raph's good, for sure. Good mobility.
Asuka, not considered that strong, but generally good against the Turtles. Mm-hmm. Not a bad counter to Raph, in fact. Nice grab.
Yeah, I love it. The little mix-up.
Yeah, the throws in this game are great. There are no startup, just like ST. There's no breaks or anything. And you can be thrown even in block stun. Really cheap.
Yeah, for sure.
All right, Raph takes first round.
2 out of 3?
3 out of 5.
3 out of 5.
Finals, yep. 3 out of 5.
Round two. Fight.
What are the mates in the background doing? They're just like freaking
hanging
out,
man. You're just watching a turtle and a girl fight. Why not? Have a good time.
Nice block. That was cool.
Just harassing with jabs. Punish. Could have done more.
Oh, that was good. Good air to air. Snuffed completely there. Nice grab.
Ooh, bring up grab.
Oh, snuffed. I think he went for another throw.
I think you're right, yeah.
All right.
So will Husbando change?
We shall see. Kals took the first game pretty commandingly, I would say. Mm. He was in control for the most part.
He really did look good, yeah.
Okay.
Dawn. Oh,
another
okay.
character that's actually very good against yep. turtles.
Has some ranged options.
Mm-hmm.
Round one. Fight!
Okay.
Yeah, a huge button there.
Yeah, so Don is known for his range. He's got yep. lots of great long-range pokes.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so he's starting to deal with Power Drill all right.
Yeah, this is working well for him. Great Fierce there.
I like the one. Range he's picking. That's a perfect spot.
Yep.
Backdash is just for safety.
Good damage. Might be able to punish. Ooh. Oh, he tried.
I think he was mashing too hard. Oh, he's got
okay,
super.
Got super.
Yeah, super builds up kind of weirdly in this game. It's on block that you build super meter.
I think you get more the less health you have or something like that.
Oh.
Oh, it snuffed his air.
Oh, it got grabbed, but it's not the kill. Can he punish? Oh, sweep.
That was a close round. So for Husbando, the Don pick has been pretty good. We'll see if he can... get comfortable.
Yeah, he definitely looked better.
Round two. Fight.
Nice anti-air. Good. What a range.
Great slide.
Mm-hmm.
I cannot remember if that move is safe or not.
Yeah, I don't remember either, but it kind of looks like it is. At least a certain range. Wake up grab. Yep. Like you said, they're one frame.
Mm-hmm.
Instant.
Okay, tried to use the invincibility on backdash to get out, but it did not work out.
Yeah, okay, that's
nice.
A good spot.
Yep.
Chance now for Husbando. Building up some bar. Look at that bar go! Look at that bar go!
Oh, clipped him.
Wake up grab? No, too far. Tried to get out of the way.
All right. So 2-0 right now. So I've been told that actually in the history of these mystery tournaments, at least the UFGT, that Slash... combo breaker ones that there's never been a reset before in the grand finals.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Wondering if Husbando can change that.
Well, he's Hope not he looking good right now. Down 2-0. Armagon, okay. Shark's pretty good.
Right.
Okay, he's gonna try it out.
Armagon.
Question is, does he know the inputs?
Round one. Fight.
So I think it's Guile inputs, if I recall correctly.
Yeah, right? The uppercut is.
Yeah,
I'm not sure if the fireball is a regular fireball or a sonic boom. Look at Baxter in the background.
Oh yeah, there you go.
Oh, man.
But the change hasn't seemed to matter that much.
Well, Kyle's has a big lead. And it's like he hasn't been trying to use the uppercut and some of his other tools, but
yeah.
Raph's buttons and the power drill have been a big problem from this whole set.
Yeah, that speed, that mobility.
Oh, there we go.
Yes, all right.
Chip.
But it's tournament point now. Kyle's threatening to take this whole thing. It's going to be a long road ahead for Husbando.
A lot of people in the crowd are yelling for Husbando, trying to give him tips. Get him closer.
Yep. Okay, he's fine. Oh, but you can flash kick. Charge time is really short.
Nice.
Yeah, Raph pressuring.
Oh,
nice
man,
throw.
Tough he's position.
Very close to taking this.
Nice neutral jump. He's got a chance. That did so much damage.
Yeah, that was good. Raph pressuring. Trying to move forward.
Okay, good jump out.
Oh,
ooh, big
the
jump
air was not there. Oh, he could've, oh, that's it.
That's it. That is it.
Congrats to Kals.
All right, he takes it 3-0 with Raph.
Wins good the stuff. Mystery Tournament at Combo Breaker 2016.
Raphael. Man, so we didn't get to see what the Grand Finals reset game would be. But just for the sake of the stream, we were going to make them play this game, but the Genesis version.
Oh, man.
So we didn't get to see that, unfortunately. But good stuff to Kyle's for taking first. Good stuff to Husbando on second. Third was Mr. Igu. And fourth place was Evil Genius' own Justin Wong.
Yeah.
Man, that was really great. Hope that you guys enjoyed it at home. Got Justin there on stage. He is the organizer of the Mystery Series here at Combo Breaker. Much love to him. He also provides most of the equipment that we use.
I think he was explaining a bit about how Armageddon works right there, but yeah. A little too late.
He's also a big fan of this game too.
Yeah, it's a good game.
Yeah, it's great.
I really enjoyed it.
Yeah, for those out there that might have thought this was my idea, it actually was originally his idea because he just loves Tournament Fighter.
Sick.
So
yeah, it's a really good game.
Yep. All right, guys. So I believe that is our time, but let us know, guys, if there's anything else going on. Thanks to everyone, by the way. Thanks for watching here on Team Spooky, as always. There is lots more action for you guys. Vampire Savior Top 8 is next, and trust me, you guys want to see that. It's very cool, great players, and it's not too often that you can see this game played at high level, so yeah. You definitely want to check it out.
Thanks for watching.